Well, Jana, so far, so many people around me have told me that they are tired of this winter. The prolonged cold temperatures and the ton of snow, well, it's affecting us, but apparently it's taking a toll on the deer population in the northern one-third part of our state as well.
Snow and sub-zero temperatures aren't new to deer, but there are some winters during which those things can get in the way of deer thriving.
The snow depth certainly affects their movements. It also makes them more vulnerable to predation by wolves. And then also, yes, they are not able to get to the forage that they would typically try to get to.
Barb Keller, the DNR Big Game Program leader, says they've already had several reports of deer eating hay meant for livestock out of desperation.
And really, during the winter months, they're just trying to maintain themselves and really slow down that loss in body weight.
Adult deer are also used to this. Typically, winter isn't a bountiful season anyway. But fawns might run into trouble.
There are some localized areas where we are having severe conditions, and you can't expect that the fawn crop is going to be impacted by those conditions. So again, that'll be the first segment of the population affected. If we were to have really severe conditions, then we might see adults being impacted. And certainly adults can also be affected by wolves taking advantage of the situation.
Keller says the last time she saw something like this, actually to a much severe degree, was back in 2013.
And that was really over, it was severe conditions over a wide area of northern Minnesota. I don't think we're quite there or maybe even near there at this point. It's more of a localized issue in the northern one-third of the state.
Right now, Keller says they are moderately concerned about the deer population in these specific areas, but prolonged severe conditions might lead to some changes for the rest of the year.
We'll take that into account when we develop our hunting regulations for this upcoming fall. In those areas where we expect that we did have some fawn mortality, we'll probably dial back the hunting regulations or the bag limits that we allowed this fall in those areas.
So what can you do, whether you're someone hoping for a successful deer hunt this year or a deer lover?
Just keep in mind, if you see some deer, don't approach them. They might be having a tough time moving around. Keep your berth from the deer and, try to avoid disturbing them as much as possible.
The good news is that Keller tells me that deer are actually pretty good at rebounding from short-term population declines like this. Doe get pregnant almost every year, and every time under normal circumstances, they are likely to have twins. So this isn't going to be a prolonged issue. Jana?
Thanks, Sharon. I learned a lot during that. Appreciate the report.